Tonight, when one wife isn't enough.
What was it like to hear your husband tell you that he was falling in love with your twin sister?
It was a bit of a surprise.
How many wives do you have?
I've got two wives.
So how does polygamy work?
The dad is not there most of the time to play his fatherly role when you want them.
Is this what happened to you as a child?
Pretty much.
I could be a second wife, maybe.
Why would that be different?
Because it's easier. Like, you know, he didn't marry on me. I was like the second.
That's right.
So you wouldn't feel betrayed in a way.
I wouldn't feel betrayed.
I think it is worth it because Mark and Ben loves me very much. It's worth it.
Hi, I'm Jenny Brockie and welcome to you all. Good to have you here. And Mark, Bell and Dorothy, welcome to you. Let's have a look at your story.
This one needs pollination.
Now I'm a bit boring, really.
Because our lives are just like anybody else's. The usual chores and shopping and gardening, not really anything out of the ordinary at all, apart from just the rather odd fact that I've got two partners, not one.
God only knows what I'd be without you.
It's our love that keeps the three of us strong. He means everything to me, and I'm not looking for any other man.
Belle and I, when we go out, we tell them that we're both Mark's wives.
You don't have any tintels. Can take all now.
No, that's a bit overdoing.
No, you
it.
Can't take all of them.
The way we've worked things out is that there is two separate relationships here. There's no three-way odd things in bed going on. They're sisters after all. That would be a bit too weird.
How many items do we have?
Do we have more than
one? 12, 3, 4.
So it's like just two husband and wife relationships with the obvious difference there's only one husband. So yes, I spend one night with Dorothy, one night with Belle, and that just seems to work.
We kiss each other goodnight, and whoever Mark is with, he goes to that room.
Night.
Night, sweets.
You too.
Sweet dreams. Okay.
Okay, so Mark, who are you legally married to?
I'm legally married to Belle.
And you and Belle met at university?
Yes, correct.
So how long had you been married before Dorothy came on the scene?
27 years.
And was that a monogamous relationship?
Oh, completely, yes.
All right. And Belle, you'd been separated at birth from Dorothy, so you were both adopted out?
Yes, into different families.
And so you wanted to find her. How long had you been looking for her?
Well, I think when I was about 30 years old, I applied to the Malaysian Registry of Births and Deaths and asked for my adoption certificates and my birth certificates. And I said, I have a twin as well, so could you send me hers too? And that's when I got her details of her adoptive family as well.
So after years of looking, you're married to Mark, you've been married to Mark for a long time, and after years of looking, you were reunited with her with the help of the ABC. Let's have a look at how that happened.
So we found them. Dorothy has landed and we'll reunite them in a few minutes.
A dream come true. Yes, it's more than I could ever hope for.
We found that she and I were so much alike in tastes, hobbies, physical traits. And now that I've found her, we know that we wouldn't die lonely. There's a future out there with her, and that we've got family, and that our lives will now change for the better.
So that's how long ago? A few years ago?
Yes, in September 2008.
So, Mark, how long after these two were reunited did you start feeling attracted to your wife's twin sister?
It happened remarkably quickly, actually. I kept a diary for many years, and one of the things I noted going back reading through it, it took about 15 days for me to realise there was something going on in my head that at the time I just didn't understand. And that's
why
what happened.
Do you think you were feeling those things? Was it because she's just like your wife?
Not just that. It's more than a physical thing. It's more than looking at someone who looks similar. It goes much deeper. It's people talk about soulmates. And I guess that's the level it goes to. It's a very deep emotional bond between people.
So you're saying 15 days when you go back through the diaries, you were starting to have those feelings that early on. Dorothy, were you having these feelings? Were you reacting the same way?
Not at the beginning.
You were married, yeah?
Yes, I was married. I was married. But my marriage was actually sort of on the rocks at the time when I met Belle and Mark. It was not going well for the past few years, in fact.
So when he told you he felt this way, how did you react?
I suppose my first response that I thought it wasn't possible, that maybe he was feeling this way because he took pity on me.
So Mark, how did you break it to your wife, Belle, that you were in love with her identical twin sister just after this reunion had taken place?
There isn't really a simple answer to that one. I guess in the end it was just I had to say something about what was going on in my head. And in the end I did say to Belle, I think I'm starting to have feelings for Dorothy like I feel for you. And we discussed it, I think, over a period of about 2 weeks before we worked out how we were going to go. What we had to do initially was make sure that Dorothy's marriage was unsalvageable. And we did put quite a bit into talking about that with Dorothy to start off with. And she did try to reconnect with her husband. It didn't work. And in the end, we ended up in the situation we are now.
Belle, after 28 years of marriage, what was it like to hear your husband tell you that he was falling in love with your twin sister?
It was a bit of a surprise, but I could understand it.
Why?
Because she's me. I mean, when Mark fell in love with me, we fell so deeply in love with each other. So it's just seemed obvious that if he sees another me, his heart would fall the same way for her.
So there was no resistance from you? Did you?
Well, it's because I could understand it, and I felt that it was very unfair that I could have such a loving marriage and hers not be the same. So when Mark said he was falling in love with her, and when we knew we couldn't salvage her marriage, all I said to Mark is, well, go tell her.
Do you think you knew what you were getting yourself into at that point?
I have to be honest and say I did not know what I was getting into.
In what way?
Because I'm very young at heart and a bit naive. and I thought, well, he'll say, oh, I love you, and she'll say, oh, and I love you back, and we all love each other and happy families. And I didn't look into it further. It didn't go beyond that.
So what sort of things surprised you about it that you hadn't expected? I mean, did you feel jealous? Did you ever?
Yes, that's what I went through. That's what I didn't think I'd go through.
How long did you go through that? Are you still going through that to some extent?
No, I'm not. Because Mark assured me that he loved me just as much. And there would be no discrepancies between his love between the two of us. And he would never leave us. He said unless one of us left him, he would never leave either of us.
I'm going to talk about some other examples of polygamy in a moment, but before I do, Peter Richardson in Sacramento, I wanted to have a chat with you about this because you've studied polygamy. I wonder if you can tell us how common it is worldwide as a phenomenon.
Well, About 85% of societies that anthropologists have studied over the years at least permit polygamous marriage, like Mark and Belle and Dorothy's marriage, for special circumstances. And many societies, it's a favored form of marriage. At least permissible and favored in many societies, most societies.
And I understand you've taken an interest in polygamy in Australia.
Yes, well, the Australian native people are interesting to anthropologists because most hunting and gathering people may permit polygamy, but in fact, very few marriages are polygamous because it's hard for men to support more than one wife, and there's a big egalitarian ethos in most hunting and gathering societies that anthropologists have studied. And Australia is a conspicuous exception. There were lots of societies in Australia, apparently, with fairly high rates of polygyny, and there was a old men ruled the societies and used religious prohibitions to prevent young men from marrying. They had to be inducted into several religious rituals before they were candidates for marriage, and they weren't candidates for marriage then until they were in their late 20s or early 30s. So that's a very unusual system.
Recently we went to Yirrkala in Arnhem Land in the Northern Territory, and we spoke to one senior woman in the community there about polygamy.
Traditionally, a man has more than one wife. He has like three or four wives. I don't have that feeling of shame if I talk about my dad having seven wives. You know, it's not shameful at all. You know, it was the way of living. My youngest mum is almost the same age as me. She's about 5 years older than me, you know what I mean? And we grew up together. All their mums treated us equally. Us kids equally, loved us equally.
And he's copying his sister and tonight.
I was counting it with my dad when he was still alive. He'd count the mum and then how many kids she had and so on, you know. And then I'd say, oh, well, what about this person, you know? And what about, and the name my brother or my sister. And she'd go, oh, yes, I forgot, you know. And, because there's so many of us. There's about 35 of us. It was a good thing. It can be a good thing, you know, to live with this big family. To tell you the truth, I never really saw any negatives. If you all go together to get something, you'd have more of this yam, you know, more of the oysters, more of the yam, the nuts, you know, there's more than having, say, five. When you just only have five, you know, in a family.
Your husband only has you. Mm. Would you be happy for there to be someone else in the family, in your family?
No, because he's not a Yolngu man. He's a non-Indigenous person.
So it's specifically for traditional
Aboriginal. Yeah. Having those seven mothers, you know, always there for you. And one dad, a very strong, powerful dad, you know, and having that values that I got from each one of those women, yeah. You know, to get that knowledge of them is who I am, what I'm made of.